to my channel. My name is Shelby, and today I'm going to be doing a Kindle Unlimited book haul. Kindle Unlimited is a service you do through Amazon. You pay $9.99 a month, and you get to read unlimited romance and other genre titles through their service. Not all of the titles are on Kindle Unlimited, but quite a few indie romances do use Kindle Unlimited. And at a time, you can take out 10 different books. And so today I'm going to be talking about 10 romances that I currently have checked out from Kindle Unlimited. As you can tell, I'm in a different location today. I am still in my bedroom, but we did get a new rocking chair for when Grayson arrives. And until he goes into his own nursery, this chair is going to be in our bedroom. So I figured this would be a really great place for me to film, especially because now being pregnant, it's a little bit more difficult to sit on the floor. This chair is actually really comfortable, so I'm really pleased with the change. As always, I'll link all the books I talk about down below, and let's get right into it. The first book that I have is Written in the Scars by Adriana Locke. I just recently heard about this over on Nicolette's channel, which is Falling Over Books, and she said that she absolutely loved this book, and I have read one series by this author, and I really enjoyed it. This is one of her older titles, and it is about a married couple who is going through infertility, and I think they want to get divorced, and it is their romance and them falling back in love. I love romances about married couples because I am a married person, and I feel like I can truly relate to their issues, especially if it has to do with infertility. I deal with infertility, if you guys didn't already know that. So it's something near and dear to my heart, and I can't wait to get to this one. The next one that I have is Sweet on You by Katana Collins. I don't know much about this one. I kind of read over the blurb and it was a little bit confusing, but I do know that the hero in the story is a baker and the heroine has a crush on him, but he turns her down when she asks him out. The cover was really adorable and I love books that have to do with cooking or baking. The next book I have is I Want to Text You Up by Tegan Hunter. This is the next book in the texting series. I really loved the first book. I read it last year, and ever since I have been wanting to read book number two and just haven't gotten around to it. This is about a college student who ends up posting an ad for a roommate, and the person who replies to the ad is none other than her best friend's ex-boyfriend. Her best friend, I believe, is the heroine from book number one, and I do remember the ex-boyfriend in that story. So he is now the hero in this story, and I really can't wait to read it. I'm assuming it's going to be a romantic comedy, which I am super in the mood for. The next one that I have is My Favorite Souvenir by V. Keeland and Penelope Ward, and this is our Book Talks pick for the month of May. This is this author duo's latest release. It just came out the end of April, and it is perfect for summer. The premise is a little convoluted, but it's about a woman who goes to this island with her fiance, and they end up breaking up while they're there, but she still wants to stay at this really nice resort. She ends up going to this resort, and she has to pretend to be this guy's sister in order to share a room with him, and it's kind of like a chance encounter. He is also pretending to be someone else, so it's kind of a big farce. It sounds really cute and perfect for summer, and I really am in the mood for a summery beachy read. The next one that I have is The Love Plan by Erica Marcellus, and this is about two best friends who end up having a one-night stand together. I think they are really drunk. The heroine remembers what happens, but the hero actually forgets that it all happened. So the next day he wakes up and he has no idea that they hooked up. He just thinks everything is like normal, and she's in love with him. So she comes up with this plan to make him fall in love with her. It sounds really cute, and the cover was really intriguing to me, so I really can't wait to pick it up. Then I have Rush by Candy Steiner, and I actually already read this book like 3 years ago when it was called Palm South University, like book one or something, but it's been quite a long time since I've read it, and since then a lot of books have come out in the series. I feel like if I was going to jump into book number two, I'd be kind of confused, so I do want to go back and reread the first book and continue on with the series. I feel like it's a very summery series because it is a college romance series. It's a new adult series that takes place at a university called Palm South University. It is kind of a mix between the TV shows Greek and Gossip Girl, and I just remember it was so much fun. It had a lot of drama. It was nothing too serious, so I think rereading it will be a really good time. Then I have Next in Line by Amy Dawes, and this is the second book in the Wait With Me series. I just recently read Wait With Me back in April, and I really enjoyed it. I gave it 4 stars. I thought it was a lot of fun, so I definitely want to continue on with this series. I believe the hero in this story is the best friend of the hero in the first story, and from what the blurb said, it's about a guy who makes out with his best friend's little sister, and I'm not sure if they didn't recognize each other or they didn't know they had the mutual acquaintance, but they decided to keep it a secret, and I'm assuming that gets pretty complicated. I'm hoping I love it because I really enjoyed book number one. It was so much fun. I'm hoping this one is also a really fun rom-com. Then I have That Second Chance by Megan Quinn. This one was on my May TBR, so I'm hoping to get to it this month. There are 3 books out in the series, and each one is about a different brother, and apparently these brothers have a curse about love where they cannot fall in love or something like that, and so this is about one of the brothers, and he ends up falling for a new girl in town, and he he's trying to break this curse. It sounds really cute. I really love Megan Quinn, so I have a feeling I'm going to like it. Then I have Wrong by Jana Austin, and I've heard amazing things about this series. I've read one of her Reindeer Falls Christmas novellas, and I really thought it was cute, so I want to go back and read some of her full-length novels. And this is about a college student who works at a coffee shop, and she keeps crushing on one of her customers who always comes in every day. And when she goes to her doctor to get birth control, it's kind of an embarrassing situation, and it turns out that the customer is her doctor, and so it's definitely a forbidden romance. I'm guessing it's an age gap as well because she is a college student and he is a doctor. I've heard this series is really funny and it just sounds like a lot of fun. The last one that I have is Not So Nice Guy by R.S. Gray. I'm trying to get through a lot of her backlist because a lot of her newer titles have been hit or miss for me, and some of her older titles as well. So I'm curious if just a couple of her books for me are hidden gems or if I love a good majority of her books. And this is a friends to lovers romance about two people who work at the same school. The hero in this story is now newly single, and the heroine has never saw him in a romantic light, but she hears through the grapevine that he is actually interested in her. And so it is their friends to lovers romance. You guys know I love friends to lovers romances. I love coworker romances. So I'm hoping that this one will be really good. So those are the 10 romances I currently have checked out from Kindle Unlimited. I'd love to hear if you've read any of these and what you currently have out from Kindle Unlimited. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys on my next one. Bye.